I've spent 10 years being vegan, but now I have 10 weeks until opening day. My fiancé and I moved out west to try to get a better connection to our food, including sourcing our own meat. We're out here, I have my Idaho resident hunting license, so this is where the rubber meets the road. I have a ton of research to do that I'm gonna share with you guys along the way, but I do not have a lot of time to do it, so it's time to get going. I'm here to eat, so let's jump into it. I started eating vegan as a teenager, and if you had asked me then why I was vegan, it was 100% only because of animal cruelty. That was my only motivation. But sadly, across the decade of being vegan, those passions that drove me to become vegan initially dulled, and it became more about health. If you were to ask me at the end of those 10 years why I was still vegan, I would have told you it was for health reasons only. So it was in the name of health that I started experimenting with putting animal products into my diet. And a few years ago, I was diagnosed with an autoimmune digestive disease, which has really changed the way I have to eat. And I'm not trying to make a statement about what diet is better for who or anything like that. One thing that I've found over the years of symptom control is that my body operates much more comfortably with animal protein. After a few years of going to the grocery store to buy meat, the guilt that made me initially want to be vegan a long time ago started coming back. So I was sitting on this line between wanting to eat animals and feeling disgusted by the fact that animals are treated like such a commodity. They're raised and harvested no different than corn, which is really what fueled my fiance and I packing everything up and moving out west. The diversity of animals out here and the opportunity for hunting is incredible, and it's a lot different than home, so it is very possible that we can sustain ourselves with meat throughout the entire year from hunting alone. And honestly, the West is just amazing. My idea of the West before we were here was huge, and it's bigger than I even anticipated. I mean, we love it out here. So I closed my business, and last spring we moved to Idaho. And since being out here, we started eating vegan again. On January 1st, I got my Idaho resident hunting and fishing license. So of course, that morning I hit the Boise River in search of our first meat meal. Eating fish is a point of debate, even within the vegan and vegetarian communities. You know, across all of my time being vegan, I had a lot of friends that ate fish either regularly or semi-regularly or when they were just craving it. And there's a lot of justifications that people would use. When I was vegan, I never ate fish simply because they were alive. That was the only reason that I needed. But there was no respect issue there. But after spending January, the entire month of January, going out trying to catch fish, and for the most part being unsuccessful, I started doing a lot of research and started really learning about fish, learning about their habitats, their habits, what they'll eat, what kind of water temperatures they like, where they like to be in the water, all sorts of things like that. And through that learning process, I established a respect for fish that I didn't even know that I didn't have. The small amount of understanding that I've established about fish has made me more curious and more respectful than I've ever been in my entire life. And if it weren't for the pursuit of fishing, I would have never even been aware that that respect was something that I lacked. Now, I really wish I had started this channel a month ago so I could have shown you all of the crazy trials and slow learning curve process that I've gone through in learning to fish, because it has been a process, but I'm going to show you guys a lot of that in the future.
Yeah, looks good.
Oh, in my finger. Ouch.
Oh, okay. There we go. Not so bad.
But for now, we're talking turkeys. Before I knew it, I was 2 months away from opening day, and I really have not done anything to get ready for turkey season, but I am very much ready for a meal of meat that is not fish. So it's time for me to start learning. I can't stress enough that this is all brand new to me, and I have not done anything to get ready other than reading the introductory chapters of these two books that I got. So I'm not trying to teach anybody anything here. I'm just trying to share my learning experience with you so that if you're in a similar situation to me and you're gonna try to go get after turkey for the first time, you can learn from my mistakes or laugh at my ugly beginner growing pains so that you don't have to go through them yourself. One of the first things that we're gonna do is pattern this shotgun. I got a Mossberg 500 specifically because this is designed to be a turkey gun. It has a turkey choke. It already has this little green glowy bead sight, whatever it is. And it has a pistol grip. I'm very comfortable with shooting rifles, so I thought with my internet research that this was gonna be a perfect gun for me. But as soon as I picked this up, which this is the first shotgun I've ever owned, I looked at it and I held it and I was like, dude, this is not a rifle. Like, I literally don't know what to do with this thing at all. And I have not begun my research. I got some practice rounds and I got some very expensive turkey rounds, but we have to pattern this thing. I have to learn about it. I have to clean it, all that stuff. So that's gonna be a lot of fun. Also, I got these books to read. The first one, Western Turkey Hunting, specifically Western, because the land out here is so different than what I'm used to. I grew up on the East Coast. I've lived on the East Coast my entire life. And I'm telling you, the weather, the land, everything out here is just a lot different. So I am very hopeful that this is gonna give me some insight that I don't have just because I have not spent any time out here. Also, turkey calls and calling. I think I am the most excited about learning to talk to turkey and learning to understand what their calls mean, you know, and being able to communicate with them in that way. So along with this, I got a couple calls. First, a crow call, also a pot call. I went crystal over slate instead of just slate because it seems like it's gonna prove a little extra challenge because you have to prep it and tune it. I'm also hoping maybe it's gonna sound a little different than what other people out there have. But either way, just the thought of having to tune it and play with it a lot, it just sounds fun. Also, I got four different mouth calls. Now, all of the calls that I got are Phelps brand. At the risk of sounding like somewhat of a fanboy, I listened to the owner of Phelps game calls on a couple podcasts, maybe just one or two podcasts, and that dude just knows what he's talking about. He's really, really passionate. He puts a lot of work into the quality control. He really cares about what he's doing. So I felt good spending a couple extra bucks on each one of these calls, knowing that what I was getting was quality and I wasn't gonna be disappointed by something that just doesn't work right. When I'm a beginner in the first place, the last thing I need is a non-dependable call. I'm gonna be spending the next month or so doing a lot of reading, a lot of research, a lot of practice calling. Again, I've never put one of these calls in my mouth. I've never touched these calls other than really taking them out of the packaging and showing them to you. So I'm gonna show you the good, the bad, and the ugly of the whole process. As it gets closer to the season, I'll be scouting locations and hopefully going out and actually seeing some turkey. All of this leading up to just 2 months from now when the season starts. Like I keep saying, I really don't have a lot of time to get into this stuff, so I'm going to be posting videos regularly over the next couple months showing you my progress, the good, the bad, and the ugly, the first time I put these calls in my mouth, and all of it leading up to turkey season, which is coming quick. I am so excited, and I'm glad to be making this video now so that I can finally start messing with all of this stuff.